Children, today we have to see about this NSAIDs, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Already we have seen the classification, already we have seen the introduction regarding these NSAIDs. These are the drugs which are used to treat the inflammation. Not only the inflammation, these drugs are also used for the treatment of fever and for the relief of pain. So they are also called as analgesics and antipyretics. So now let us see about the classification of this non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is NSAIDs. So these are classified in these following classes, that is salicylates, N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives, which are also called as pyrimates, aryl acetic acid derivatives, propionic acid derivatives, also called as profans, para-aminophenols or enilides, pyrazolone and pyrazolidine dione derivatives, and oxycams and the miscellaneous. These are the different classes of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Now let us see in detail about these different classes of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Now let us see the classification of these NSAIDs in detail. The first class is salicylates. So the general structure of these salicylates is this ardohydroxybenzoic acid. This is the general structure for all the salicylates. And when we come to the examples of these salicylates, aspirin, which is also called as acetyl salicylic acid, sodium salicylate, salicylate, methyl salicylate, phenyl salicylate, etc., are the examples that comes under this salicylate. When we see the structure of this aspirin, so which is also called as acetyl salicylic acid, so it contains the carboxylic acid group and the acetyl group, both are the position. So this is acetyl salicylic acid, acetyl and salicylic acid. And the other example here is sodium salicylate. This is the sodium salt of salicylic acid, which is sodium salicylate. So these two are the examples which are mentioned in your syllabus. And next, when we come to the next class, that is N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives. So the basic structure for this anthracnic acid is, so it contains carboxylic acid group and also amino group. So in this amino group, one of the hydrogen is replaced by either alkyl group or aryl group. Here, since it is N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives, this R will be the aryl group. So the examples of this N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives are mefenamic acid, meclofenamate sodium, or meclofenamic acid, flufenamic acid. These are the examples for N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives, which is having the basic structure of this. To this aniline, so this carboxylic group is attached, or to this benzoic acid, this amino group is attached. So N-aryl anthracnic acid derivatives. So when we see the examples, meclofenamic acid. So this meclofenamic acid, the structure of this meclofenamic acid or meclofenamate sodium is, so here this aryl group is methyl dichlorophenyl. So and this H is replaced by sodium, meclofenamate sodium. This is an structure for this meclofenamate sodium. And when we see the example of this mefenamic acid, so here also the hydrogen of this amino group, it is replaced by dimethyl phenyl. So dimethyl phenyl anthracnic acid is methanamic acid. So these are the examples of N aryl anthracnic acid derivatives. So these are also called as phenamates. Phenamates means phenyl anthracnic acid derivatives. Phenyl anthracnic acid derivatives. This aryl group is generally the substituted phenyl group. So these are also called as phenamates. See the next class, that is aryl acetic acid derivatives. And this aryl acetic acid derivatives, so they are again further classified as indole derivatives, indene derivatives, pyrrole derivatives and others. So this aryl acetic acid derivatives means, so this hydrogen, one of the hydrogen of this acetic acid is replaced by aryl group. So now let us see in detail about this each class, that is indole. The example of this indole is indomethacin, and the example of indene is sulindac, and the example of pyrrole is tolmetin zomperac, and the others that comes under this aryl acetic acid derivatives is ketorolac and diclofenac. So these are the examples that comes under this each class of aryl acetic acid derivatives. Now let us see the structures of each class. So here the structures, they will differ only in this aryl group. So now let us see the structures. First let us see the structure of indomethacin. So this indomethacin contains indole in its structure. So this indole is bench pyrrole, is indole. So this pyrrole is fused with benzene. Bench pyrrole is indole. So this indole, it contains acetic acid and also methyl group and also para-chlorobenzoyl group and methoxy group. So this is the structure of indomethacin. So to this indole, these are the substituents. So here at third position acetic acid, and at second position methyl group, and to this nitrogen para-chlorobenzoyl group is attached and also methoxy group is attached. So this is indomethacin. And next let us see the example for sulindac, the structure of sulindac. So this sulindac, it is also a fused ring . So the difference between this indole and indene is, so here this nitrogen, it is replaced by carbon. So this is indole and this is indene. Simply the nitrogen here indole, in this indole is replaced by carbon. So this is indole and this is indene. And this indene, the example for this indene is sulindac. And here also it is an derivative of acetic acid. And now let us see the examples for pyrrole, that is tolmetin and zomperac. Tolmetin and zomperac are the examples for pyrrole derivatives. So this pyrrole is a heterocyclic ring . A five-member ring which contains nitrogen. So this, to this pyrrole, it contains acetic acid,
methyl and this toluene carboxy group. So it contains, since it contains the toluene, it is named under tolmetine. Tolmetine, which is an example for pyrrole. And next, let us see the structure for zomperac. It is also a pyrrole derivative, which is an example for aryl acetic acid derivative. So this is an example for zomperac. So here the difference between this tolmetine and zomperac is, here it contains the toluene and here it contains parachlorophenyl group. So this is the difference, and it also contains the methyl group. This zomperac also contains the methyl group. So this is an example for pyrrole derivatives. And after the last under this aryl acetic acid derivatives is others are miscellaneous aryl acetic acid derivatives, that is ketorolac and diclofenac. So this ketorolac, the structure of this ketorolac is, so this is the structure of ketorolac, which comes under this miscellaneous aryl acetic acid derivatives. And next, let us see the structure of diclofenac. So this diclofenac, which contains the dichlorophenyl group, and this is the structure of diclofenac. Let us see the next class, that is propionic acid derivatives, which is also called as profens. So here, so this is a propionic acid. So to this propane, carboxylic acid group is attached, so propionic acid. So this propionic acid, to this propionic acid, aryl group is attached, or we can call it as phenyl propionic acid derivatives or profens. Phenyl propionic acid derivatives or profens. And the examples of these propionic acid derivatives are ibuprofen, phenoprofen, ketoprofen, naproxen. So these are the examples of propionic acid derivatives, that are ibuprofen, phenoprofen, ketoprofen, naproxen. Now let us see the structures of these propionic acid derivatives or profens. So here these structures, they only differ in this aryl group. They only differ in this aryl group. So now let us see the structure of ibuprofen. So this ibuprofen contains a substituted phenyl group, that is isobutyl phenyl propionic acid derivatives. So this butyl group, which is an isobutyl phenyl propionic acid derivatives is, propionic acid derivative is ibuprofen. Isobutyl phenyl propionic acid derivatives. Here this butane is isobutyl. And the next example given in your syllabus is this naproxen. So this naproxen contains the substituted aryl group, that is methoxy naphthalene. Methoxy naphthalene. So this methoxy naphthalene is the substituted aryl group in this. So it is called as naproxen. Methoxy naphthyl propionic acid derivatives is naproxen. So these are the examples for propionic acid derivatives, that is ibuprofen, phenoprofen, ketoprofen and naproxen. When we see particularly the structures of this ibuprofen and naproxen, so this ibuprofen contains isobutyl phenyl propionic acid and this naproxen contains methoxy naphthalene propionic acid derivative. And next, after this propionic acid derivatives, that is para amino phenols, or these are also called as enolates, para amino phenols or enolates. So this para amino phenol contains to this benzene this hydroxy group and this amino group, both are para to each other. So para amino phenol or hydroxy benzene, para amino hydroxy benzene or para amino phenol. So it also contains this aniline. So these are also called as enolates. So the examples of these para amino phenols or enolates are paracetamol, which is also called as acetaminophen, phenacetin, enicidin, probenzid. So now let us see the structures of this. The first, paracetamol. So this paracetamol, which is also called as acetaminophen. So this paracetamol, which is also called as acetaminophen, this is the structure of that paracetamol. Acetyl amino phenol. So it is also called as acetaminophen. So this para amino phenol, to this para amino phenol, this acetyl group is attached. So it is also called as acetyl amino phenol, acetaminophen or para acetamino phenol. So both these are para to each other, acetamino group and hydroxy group, both are para to each other. So it is also called as paracetamol or acetamino phen. And the structure of phenacetin, so it is also similar to that of paracetamol. So it also contains acetamino group and ethoxy group. So it is phenacetin. So as set of the paracetamol, this phenacetin also contains acetamino group, and at to this para position ethoxy group is present. So this is phenacetin. So these two are the examples given in your syllabus for para amino phenols. Okay, so these para amino phenols or enolates, the examples of these para amino phenols or enolates are paracetamol, phenacetin, enicidin and probenzid. So it contains the amino group and hydroxy group, both are para to each other on this benzene ring. So they are para amino phenols. Again, the examples: paracetamol, phenacetin, enicidin and probenzid. After these para amino phenols, the next category is pyrazolone and pyrazolidine dione derivatives. So this name, it indicates that it contains pyrazole. So the pyrazole is a heterocyclic ring which contains two nitrogens in the 5-member ring adjacent to each other, that is at 1, 2, two positions. If nitrogens are present, it is called as pyrazole. So the name tells us that it contains the pyrazole rings, and this category is pyrazolone and pyrazolidine dione derivatives. Now let us see the examples of this class, and are antipyrine, analzine, aminopyrine, phenylbutazone, oxyphenbutazone. These are the examples for pyrazolone and pyrazolidine dione derivatives. Now let us see the structures of these examples. Antipyrine. So this antipyrine contains pyrazole and one keto group at fifth position. So this is antipyrine. So to this pyrazole, so at first position phenyl group, at second and third positions methyl groups, and at fifth position we can observe this keto group. So this is pyrazole own, pyrazole, and at fifth position own. So it is pyrazolone derivative, pyrazolone derivative. So this is 1-phenyl, 2,3-dimethyl pyrazole, 5-own. 1-phenyl, 2,3-dimethyl 5-pyrazolone. That is antipyrine, which is an example of pyrazolone derivative. The next example given in your syllabus is phenylbutazone. Phenylbutazone. So this phenylbutazone also contains this pyrazole ring, so this is pyrazole ring, so it contains two keto groups to this pyrazole, so it is also called as pyrazolidine dione. So pyrazolidine dione. So this is unsaturated, it is saturated pyrazole. Saturated pyrazole is pyrazolidine. So to this pyrazolidine, two keto groups are present. So pyrazolidine dione. Pyrazolidine dione. And the example of this pyrazolidine dione is phenylbutazone. To this phenylbutazone, it contains the butyl group and two phenyl groups at first and second positions. So this is an example for pyrazolidine dione. Dione means it contains two keto group. Pyrazolidine means saturated pyrazole. And since it contains the phenyl, two phenyl groups at first and second position, and a butyl group at fourth position. So phenyl butyl pyrazolidine dione is phenylbutazone. So these are the examples given in your syllabus for pyrazole and pyrazolidine diones. So once again, the examples of this pyrazolone and pyrazolidine diones are antipyrine, analzine, aminopyrine, phenylbutazone, and oxyphenbutazone. The next class is oxycams. So this oxycams contains the basic ring, that is benzothiazine. The basic ring in these oxycams is benzene and thiazine ring. So the examples of these oxycams is pyroxycam, isoxycam, meloxycam, tinoxycam. So you can observe the suffix oxycams. So this comes under this oxycam category. So once again, the examples are pyroxycam, isoxycam, meloxicam and tinoxicam. So in your syllabus it is given pyroxicam. So when you observe the structure of this pyroxicam, so this pyroxicam contains the different substance. You can observe the different substance, this hydroxy group and this methyl group and these two oxygens on this sulfur and this heterocyclic pyridine ring. So these are the different substance which are present on this benzothiazine ring, which is the basic ring of this oxycams. So it contains hydroxy group, and to this nitrogen methyl group is attached, and beside that the pyridine ring is attached to this ring as a substituent. So this called as pyroxycam. And the last category of these NSAIDs is miscellaneous. The examples which comes under this miscellaneous is silicoxib, rificoxib, valdoxib, nimusilide. So these are the examples which comes under this miscellaneous non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Silicoxib, rificoxib, valdecoxib, nimusilide. So this is the structure of silicoxib. So it contains the pyrazole ring. The main ring in this silicoxib is pyrazole, and the different substance you can observe in this pyrazole ring. But this is not mentioned in your syllabus, but it is one of the important non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. So the examples which comes under this miscellaneous is silicoxib, rificoxib, valdecoxib, nimusilide. So this is the classification of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs.